Now we will discuss coefficients for measuring skewness. So the first one I am going to discuss, Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness. So it is defined as SK is equal to mean minus mode whole divided by standard deviation, or you can write like mean minus mode whole divided by sigma, because sigma is standard deviation. So if your skewness value is less than 0, then it implies negatively skewed distribution. Now if skewness value is greater than 0, then this implies positively skewed. And if skewness value is 0, then you can say your distribution is symmetrical. Now I'm just taking a sample problem. Suppose if you have data with mean is equal to 19, mode value is equal to 20, and standard deviation value is given 25, then what is the value of Carl Pearson's skewness you have to tell about, that is SK you have to find out. So its solution is, you can write Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness is equal to SK, it is equal to mean minus mode whole divided by sigma. So you can write mean value is 19 here, mode value is 20, and it is divided by 25. So your skewness value is equal to minus 0.04. So there is very slight negative skewness we are looking, since skewness value is very low, hence this could count as a symmetric distribution as skewness is so small. If you have to speak very precisely, then you can say it is negatively skewed function. Otherwise you can take it as a symmetric distribution because its value is very low. Now we will discuss about range of Carl Pearson's skewness, or you can say limits for Carl Pearson's skewness. So basically minus 3 is the minimum value of Carl Pearson's skewness, and its maximum value is 3. So it will be always lie between minus 3 to 3. Now we will discuss Bowley's coefficient of skewness.